Alright, I got a chest cam on. Seeing the shadows there, maybe. Chest cam. I got a tachometer that I hooked up temporarily right there. You see, it just kind of goes around here and then the excess is back here. Got A260 tooth torque converter, 20x7x8 Ken of Scorpions, air filter, header, RLV muffler, headlight, tail light. So I'm going to maybe take it on a trip. This engine doesn't seem extremely strong. I had a 37 jet, 37 thousandths, and I don't know if it's running a little rich. It seems to be running good, but maybe it's just because it's heavier. It doesn't seem as fast, and it's got a brand new belt on the torque converter, which usually translates into a kind of a mushy feel until they start getting a little grabby. But I'm going to take it up on the hill real quick, see how it does. This engine isn't even broken in yet, and it's got the original, you know, the first oil change in there. Or I haven't even changed it yet. So, and this thing I noticed when I start going fast, it starts vibrating. I think it's just, you know, when I first took off, I noticed, wow, this thing is so smooth, and it is smooth at lower RPM, but then at higher RPM, it starts really shaking, like vibrating. And maybe tuning the jet will help that, or I don't know. But it climbs good. But if this Predator engine ends up being a dud, I can just stick another one in there. I haven't been up here in quite a while, so there might be some giant things underneath these bushes. Oh, and another thing, I weighed myself with all my gear. I got a backpack on with all kinds of stuff in there, and tire patch kit, tool kit. And I'm 209 pounds with all this stuff. And I drank a big thing of water. There was a giant bear around the property last week. So I'm kind of, I mean, usually they'll just run away, but I'm looking out for them. Fall colors are pretty crazy up here. All right, let's see what's up. I don't think there'll be any mud. It's been whoa. It's been real dry. I almost got caught in a rut there. Whoa! There's something large and hidden I just ran over. Yeah, but this bike's pretty cool. Yeah, so I got Kevlar and, you know, armored knees and my jeans. And I have big old dual sport boots, mesh jacket, helmet, two GoPros. Kind of wary of stuff hidden beneath this grass because I haven't been up here. Wow, the fall colors are crazy. Whoa. Yeah, see, that just about wiped me out. I already tweaked my knee yesterday. I just took it for a quick shakedown spin. Yeah, I think I'm going to be ripping very fast on this overgrown stuff because you never know what's under here. Oh, I didn't change my foot pegs yet, and look what happens. Yeah, see, this is why I like the A262. The one part about the A262 that isn't good is when you're just trying to go slow and idle around, it's, you know, driving at 3,000 RPM. Wow, there's some nasty stuff hidden under this stuff. Gotta be careful. It wants to wheelie too. Oh, there's a big rock. Okay, this is that really steep part. It accelerates right up there. Just my brake a little, it's starting to stretch out. Yeah, so everything's brand new on this. I got 6.5. Actually, let me go up there. It's up there. I got 6.5 PSI in the front and rear. Yeah, so I'm 185 pounds. I've been having all summer pretty much. But with all this, I'm 209. So. This is that crazy steep one. I'm on it. Man, my left knee is tweaked. Way to break in a predator. Alright, that's all this stuff. Whoa! I think that's a new fallen tree. Pretty up here. Wow, my knee is tweaked. That sucks. Cool shot. I don't have real high hopes for the top speed of this thing. I mean, this engine isn't broken in yet. It does good on the trails though. I think the extra weight translates into a little smoother ride. Like the frame will take a little bit more of the bumps. You know, absorb some of that energy just from the mass. Then, you know, like the CT200U, but I also think this frame is extremely stiff compared to the CT200UEX, which makes it a little bit more, and the seat isn't quite as cushy and fat, so it makes it a little rougher. Well, but yeah, it does good. I'm definitely keeping, like, if I sell some mini bikes, this will be the one I keep, just because of the big tubes, and it's just awesome. I got the, oh, another thing I got is the EBC 304 brakes, which work great. They're the non-grooved ones. The 304Gs are the grooved, and they're all out of stock. Man, it's really, see, it hasn't rained in a long time, so we're getting crazy. That's what I just came up. So we're getting crazy kind of colors real early. And we had a couple of pretty hard freezes. I think that contributed to it, but yeah, it's really, yeah, this brake's working good, tire's working good, CVT's working good, Predator's working good on the slower stuff. We'll see how it does at higher speed. Started vibrating the other day, maybe like, ow, 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 ow. There's one that goes out there somewhere. Ooh, that's a new tree down. Ah, lots of trees down. Yeah, this one over here. Check this one out. Oh man. Well, I'm not gonna be clearing logs today, so. That's quite a, that'd be quite a chore getting around that. It's like 80 some degrees out here and I'm pretty hot, so I'm not gonna. This is just an initial test anyways. Hate not knowing what's under this overgrowth. Oh. Super sketch. Oh, there's a big turkey. Or no, that's a hawk. Man, the other, see that thing? It's flying through the trees. Man, the other day, I came up, I wish I had my, it's over here. I wish I had my GoPro on. I came up here for the, you know, the initial shakedown test. And I was coming up the Jeep Trail here. And there, I thought I saw a turkey flying. You know, they fly low, kind of fast. I thought I saw a turkey, and then I looked, and it was a giant hawk carrying a dead squirrel. It's like a 5-foot wingspan hawk. See, here goes these foot pegs. And I don't think I've ever seen that. I also saw a woodchuck the size of a dog and a deer, but yeah, that hawk was amazing. Okay, something got me over here on the way up. Oh, what it was. Almost threw me off. And down here, I think it was. Somewhere around here. It was right there. And of course, it runs a lot like the other mini bikes. Except you can tell it's beefier and heavier, and I think the seat doesn't have enough cushion. It's bigger than the CT200U, but it just squashes flat as soon as you sit on it. There's no extra cushion, so I might take it apart and put better foam in there, because it's like brand new and it just squashed right flat. This is really steep too. Good test for the brakes. And I fenced this all in for some reason. Foot peg. Wonder if we can make it up there. I'll try that real quick. That's something you can't do without a torque converter and some speed. Yeah, it does it. I'm gonna be feeling this ride tomorrow, man. My knees and my back, and this is everything. This seat is the worst of all the seats. I can tell already. It's brand new and it's just flat. That's the first thing I noticed when I sat on this bike without even riding it. So when you do hit something, you're already squashed down in the seat and there's no extra cushion. That combined with the, it's kind of intimidating when you haven't done this in a while. That combined with the, what am I trying to say? The stiff frame. It's pretty brutal ride when you hit bumps. I definitely got to do something about that. Okay.